Hi everyone and welcome back. In this video, we are going to talk about callback, promises and async await. While writing the Node.js code or JavaScript code, we might encounter this situation where we need to figure out, should I use callback, should I use promises, or let's go ahead with async await. Okay. So this is a webinar on JavaScript and we are going to talk about how to write asynchronous code in a particular loop, like for loop, for each loop, map, reduce, filter, how you can write the asynchronous code, like making an API call inside a loop. And first, before that, we will try to understand what is callback, what is promises, what is async await, and when to choose what. Okay, so it will be more over like coding exercise. We will write code and we will try to understand how we are doing it, how we are writing callback, how we are converting a callback into promise, or then we are converting it back to async await. Okay, so we will start with very basic examples and try to understand it. So consider that I'm writing a simple function. So I'm writing a print function and we will talk about the print function overall. It is taking string as an argument. Okay, I will be writing a simple function and we'll see how it works, and then we'll convert this function into a callback function to achieve what we want. Okay, set timeout, and what I'm doing is, in set timeout, I wanted to do something which I will be executing here, like console.log string. So I have written asynchronous code using set timeout. It will actually take this delay, and this delay we have randomized it. Method.floor, and what we are saying is method.random. We are giving the random times in the multiple of 100. So this time is in the millisecond. Okay, so this is a basic function we have written. Now, what if you wanted to call this for different characters? String will be a simple character, alphabetic character. So let's say I have created another function. Function is print all. And what this print all is doing, it will be calling this function multiple times. Okay, like I have a print function passing a. Similarly, I will be calling this multiple times. Okay, here I'm passing character B, here I'm passing character C. Okay, and what expected output I am looking for is, I want to print the values coming something like this, A, comma B, comma C. I mean, I want to maintain the sequence. Okay, now from this particular code, do you see that sequence will be maintained? No, right? Because the set timeout will be a random timeout it is allocating for each and every call. So you are not maintaining a particular sequence. Maybe B will come first, C will come first, or A will come first. So first of all, how can we fix this problem using callback? What we are saying is, first we will wait for the callback for the first function, then we will call the print B, then we will call the print C. It is same as, okay, consider this is an asynchronous function. We call it once, then we will wait until the response is received, then we will call it again, we will wait for the response, and then we will call it again. So this function is written without callback and promises, and now we will convert this function into callback based or promise based. Okay, so what change we will do here is, first we will convert this function to the callback. And converting any function to callback is very easy. I guess here we just need to provide a callback function. Okay, and once you are able to print it, what you need to do is, you need to call the callback. In the callback, you can actually pass the empty, whatever you wanted to return from the function. So callback functions are those functions who are returning another function. It's like a higher order function which is taking function as an argument and returning a function with the data. Okay, now how you will call it? The calling sequence will now change. Here it is taking two arguments. Print function is taking two arguments, some string, some character, and the callback function. Okay, so while calling this, you have to pass the second argument, which is a callback function. So either you write this is a function, or we can actually, sorry, we can actually use the callback function here in this particular case. So I will be using arrow functions. So this is our callback function. Now, whatever I am doing here, that thing I am doing once I received the callback from this print function. So now I can do actually, I can call print B and then I can call print C, right? So this will work perfectly fine. There is no issues. I just need to change this to print A to print B, print C. In this case, we are able to achieve what we are looking at, right? So print will call, it will return the callback after some time, then we are calling print B, then we are calling print C. But here you see that whenever we try to write the code like this, we will end up inside a callback hell. It's a very simple example, so it's not any problem in writing code like this. But when we write a dependent callbacks, okay, once this callback is resolved, then we are doing some another call, then we are waiting for it, then we are calling another, and you keep adding the functions inside C, this print C, then it becomes a callback and it doesn't look good, right? Then how can we actually improvise this set of code, either using promises or something? First of all, avoid writing these nested callbacks. So this is still fine, two-level nesting, okay? You have this callback function, you are waiting for something, and then this is still fine. But when you do a deep down nesting, then it become a problem. Okay, so how can you fix this? This is a simple callback example. So what we can do is we can introduce a promises. Okay, promises are native to ES6, and how we can create a promise? Simple, using a new promise, which will take two argument, right? It's a callback function. It has a resolve and reset. Okay, and whatever you wanted to do is, now it is a resolve promise. You can actually convert the callback function into a promise wrapper. What you just need to do is, once the that asynchronous operation is done, you will resolve or you will reset. So if we talk about this example, how can we convert this into a promise? It is simple, you just return the promise. Return new promise. Okay, it takes two argument. It's a callback function. You have to wrap everything inside it. Okay, now I can put everything inside it. We don't need to have this callback thing now. We will remove it. And here we have a set timeout. So instead of returning callback, what we will do, we will resolve this. That means we are returning a resolved promise from here. Okay, so now we just created, removed the callback, and we created a promise wrapper. Okay, so whenever we got this data, so asynchronous operation here is this set timeout. Okay, so there is a function, you are doing some HTTP call, and once the response is received from that HTTP call, you will resolve the promise. So indirectly, this function is returning a promise, either resolved or rejected. In our case, we are resolving it only, so it is a resolved promise. Now, instead of doing this nested callback, we can just print all, and we can actually modify this code. Here we are passing this character, and we will be calling dot then, because this function is returning a promise. Okay, dot then, and it's a callback. In dot then, we can actually again call this return print with another argument, and this is again further, because this is returning again promise, so you can again do the chaining. And you can again say, I will return print C, right? And you can have a catch also if you are just throwing some exceptions from that. It's a for safe side. But in our case, we don't have this particular situation here. Console.log, do whatever you wanted to do with error. Okay, so here print A is returning promise. So whenever the promise is resolved or rejected, this will call this dot then. If promise is resolved, then first callback will execute. If promise is rejected, then catch will execute. Okay, so now we have returned this in the promise view. But does it look like good enough? Can we still improvise it? Yes, I mean, you don't need to write too many lines of code to just return a promise. I mean, you can just simply say, return this, then we have dot then. I mean, this is just about refactoring or cleanup, you can say, because you don't need to, we are writing a single line of code in the arrow function. So you don't need to focus on writing this much. You can just write a catch block, and then because it's also a single line, so you can just remove these braces. Yeah, plain and simple, right? This is using promises. Now a further one level extend, if we do this, then we can also write it using async await. So if I will just write the async await function here. So async await function requires two things. When you are using async await, first of all, you have to convert that function as async. Async, then you can await for promises here. So what I will do is, I can await for first print function passing character A. Similarly, I can await for B, await for C. It will maintain the sequence because indirectly, it is actually blocking the path. What it is saying is, from line number this, it will await. This will not execute until unless this is returned. This will not, C will not execute until unless A and B has returned the value. So automatically we are able to maintain the sequence. It will return A after 1 second, B after 1 second, C. Okay. This is a plain and simple, but here we have these independent calls. Like print A doesn't need to do anything with print B, with print C. What if we have a dependent calls, means the output of print A is being fed to the print B function and print C. Okay, that will be a different scenario, and let's see how we can deal with this. So in that case, what we will do is, let's go with the callback style first, string, and here we have a current argument, and in this we will just convert this back to our old way. Set timeout, let me just see if everything is closing. Okay, so in callback we can actually return things. What we are returning is the current and the previous. Okay, so here we are getting previous is initially will be empty because this is what we are calling for the first time. So I will say previous and current. Previous will be undefined for now, and current we are already getting. So first time we are calling previous will be undefined, we will pass current as a character as A. Okay, and this is what we are resolving, means this data we are sending to the callback output, right? Now if I go back to the callback way, what I can do is, let's create a boundary here. We are converting this to the callback way again. Okay, so here function print all, at least we can copy this, and then we'll modify this. We don't need async await now using callbacks. Print all. Okay, so here what we are doing is, we are actually calling this print function and passing the empty string and the current value, and here you are also getting some result from the callback, right? You see, callback is giving you some value. So here you will get that data. You can say value. Right, earlier callback was returning nothing. So we kept this empty. Now we are passing string, which is empty initially, then current string, which is character A, and the value. Value is this callback which is returning concatenation of previous and current. Now, once this is done, we can actually call the other callback, and we can call the other callback, and we'll see how that is happening. Okay, so you can say we received the value. So this value will become now current, or we can use the result for proper. We got the result. Now we will pass the result as the current, sorry, previous, and current will become B for this. Again, we got some result from this callback. This will become result and current will become C. Okay, and you keep actually print this console dot log value. Okay, here what you keep doing is you are actually concatenating the values A with B with C. It will return A. We are passing A and B, so it will return as A concatenated with B. Same result we are passing here, so it will result A, B, C. Okay, simple example. Here what we are doing is these calls are dependent. Output of print A is dependent, out of print B is dependent on print A, print C is dependent on print B and print A, right? So same thing, if you try to write it with the help of promises, right? Then again, so this is the callback we understood. I will keep this code, and what I will do is I will write the fresh one for the promises from here. Okay, so let's convert this into promises. So what we are doing is here still we have a previous and current, we will not have a callback. Okay, so let's call it as a previous. Sorry, I think we made a small mistake. This is a previous and current. Okay, now coming back to the promises, here it will return a promise. So what we are saying is return new promise. This is how we do. So what I am doing is return new promise, and I will resolve and reject. And I will put everything inside it. And currently we are resolving the promise. So I will resolve with this data. Callback will be removed. Now we are not using callback. Sorry for the indentation and all. So we are returning a promise from this print function, right? Now what we can do is we are calling this in the promise way. So if we just change it to that way, here what we are doing, print current, previous and current, and it is returning a promise for us. So we can simply say dot then, it will return the result. Okay, that result we will use to pass to another function, another call. Let me just close this. Okay, now we got the result. We will pass this to another function, return print, and we will pass the result and second character B. Okay, this again will return a promise. We will get the result. Okay, so here we are doing the same thing, return results with C. Okay, so this is another way of doing the same thing with the help of promises. You can actually, you don't need these extra parentheses because we are returning only a single line of code. So you can actually optimize this a little bit. This is returning a promise. Then you can do a dot then result, and you can just remove these backticks parentheses. Okay, this is plain and simple code we have written. Print B, print C, right? Now we are able to achieve the dependency, right? Whatever the output we are getting, we are passing it to the print B function. Then the output we are getting, we are passing it to the print C function. Okay, same thing if we wanted to achieve with async await, that is also simple. We already have written async await. So let's just copy this and I will convert this into async await also. So this is my async function and print all, right? Now these calls are dependent. Okay, so what I will do is I will actually get the output from this await. I'm awaiting for this promise, awaiting for this promise. Then this output I can pass to another function. Okay, so here you can say const out2, out1, await print again, and you can actually pass out and character B. Similarly, you can actually, we don't need to actually print this out1 and out2, but we have to pass it, so we are assigning these back. This is out 1, this is out 2. Okay, this is how we are able to pass the dependent values, because it will not execute until this is resolved. So we will get the output from the print function and then we are passing it. Similarly, this print function, we are passing out 1. So it will not execute until the out 1 line is resolved. Okay, so these are actually very basic examples I tried to cover. How to write callback, how to convert a callback into promises, and then convert that back to async await. Okay, next thing we can talk about is writing the asynchronous code in a loop. That is most of the time we face challenges. What is the best way to write async await in a loop? What is the best way to write a promise chaining? How to execute promises together using promise.all? That I'm covering in the part 2 of this video. Okay, thanks everyone.